Now that President Trump has eliminated the Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals, or DACA, and charged Congress to find a solution within 6 months, what will happen to those DACA recipients during the interim period? How will the renewals work? I spoke with local immigration attorney Elizabeth Wittemeyer about those issues.
If you're a DACA recipient, it's a two-year grant of that status, that temporary, you know, status, deferred status. And you can't renew that that status. So say my status is going to run out in January 1. I can't apply. I have to wait at least 90 days before that January 1 date, so 3 months before I can apply. So anybody who is expiring between now and March but has that three-month window can apply. The problem is, you know, if you expire but are outside of that window, then you're not going to be able to apply for renewal. And just in general, you're not going to be able to apply for renewal. So all the many people that are outside of that, just say that my status expires in April, you know, I'm out of luck. I'm not going to be able to reapply. It's also very difficult. What I am seeing is sort of the bigger consequences of all of this. So kids that have jobs, or young people that have jobs or driver's licenses, now are not going to be able to renew those things. They're not going to be able to keep their jobs. And if they're doing higher education, sometimes they're not going to be able to stay in school because they will no longer be eligible for several different, you know, if they applied for scholarships or did different things like that, they're not going to be able to get that. And they're not going to be able to renew their driver's licenses, which is incredibly important for jobs and just to be able to live.
Since President Trump's announcement, Wittemeyer said she has received many calls from clients who are scared during these uncertain times, especially with the stepped-up ICE enforcement. Sheila Henderson, Executive Director of Integrated Community, a nonprofit corporation in Steamboat Springs, Colorado, dedicated to assisting immigrants in the community, also saw the fear in DACA recipients following the Trump administration's DACA decision.
So after Trump won, because he had been stating that he was going to get rid of it, we had a lot of fear. In fact, we had several youth on suicide watch over it. It was interesting to see which children were extremely afraid and which were just rolling with it because they knew they had no control over it. But they've definitely been getting their renewals in quicker since then. But yes, the fear was overwhelming. We dealt with a lot of it here, not just with DACA, but with everything.
This Fox News poll shows that 86% of those polled are in favor of DACA recipients receiving work permits, and 79% are in favor of U.S. citizenship. 12% are opposed to Dreamers receiving work permits, and 19% are opposed to U.S. citizenship. Until Congress reaches a legislative solution to determine the status of DACA recipients, I asked Wittemeyer how she advises her clients during this interim period.
I'm telling them what I've always told them. You know, pay your taxes, learn English, do everything to the extent possible by the book. You know, if you can, if you qualify for one of these undocumented driver's licenses, do that. You know, try to follow the law to the letter. But now with the new under Trump and with the new enforcements and with the end of DACA, what we're also doing is we're doing these civil document packets for parents to have powers of attorney and different things like that. So if they get deported, you know, there's somebody that can take over with the kids and can sort of wind down their affairs, sell their homes, sell their cars, different things like that.
For more information about DACA, please visit the Department of Homeland Security at www.dhs.gov.